The sandy expanse of Rajasthan may be a romantic destination for the enterprising travelers, but it certainly is a gruesome terrain for the local populace. If water is life, Rajasthan has little of it. This is Avinashi, a hamlet in the Sikar district of Rajasthan. Till a few years back, Avinashi, like most of the neighboring areas, witnessed an acute water crisis. Villagers, particularly women, were destined to take long treks across arid stretches for a pitcher of water. The hostile conditions often forced the menfolk to migrate to cities for a livelihood.
कभी कभी थोड़ी थोड़ी बरसात आ जाए कोई पानी बरसात बरसे जींस कोई बादरो फादरो और जब भी पड़ जाता आदर्श हो तो अब पानी पानी ना होगा तो नाच कोड़ा सा होगा सारो भी कोड़ा सा होगा
हमारा गांव में साहब कम से कम 300 कुआं करीबन 300 कुआं हैं उनमें से 250 कुआं में बिल्कुल सूखे पड़े हुए हैं और कोई 50 कुआं में पानी है वो भी बिल्कुल कम है
जद कदी एमपी एमएलए आवे छे जहां उसमें पुकार करना था मां कहीं पानी की कमी छे सड़कों की कमी छे तो सब झूठी आमल भर जा छे और फिर वोट लिया और कोई को आवे
रामदयाल जी ने पड़ोस में खूब काम करया
नांडू In 2001, when the PHD Rural Development Foundation took up the challenge of setting up water harvesting check dams in the area, it was not an easy task to win the faith and confidence of the villagers. Even more so, since it required a minimum of 25% contribution from them. Their apprehension was not wrongly founded either. Similar government projects had failed earlier. The locals were not sure if these check dams would withstand the water current and not prove disastrous for their habitat and their own lives. As their initial apprehensions gave way to trust, the check dam project began to take shape in the Aravallis. Avinashi is not an isolated case. Over the last decade, PHDRDF, with the aid from national and international charitable institutions and from its members, has implemented about 100 rainwater harvesting projects across 220 villages in Rajasthan. With an approximate outlay of ₹4.5 crores, a new life has emerged from the barren womb of the earth. The check dams have not only transformed the landscape of the place, but also affected the lives of its inhabitants.
गांव में ऐसा ही किया है गांव की चारों ओर इस टाइम ऐसी पोजीशन है जैसे गंगा बह रही हो हजारों बीघा में गेहूं पैदा हुए हैं हमारे को दूर दराज से गेहूँ और चावल लाने की कोई रास्ता नहीं इस टाइम इस एनीगढ़ से गांव दूधावास यहां से 4-5 किलोमीटर है वहां तक पानी बह रहा है गाय भैंस भेड़ बकरी जंगल के जानवर जिसमें हम नीलगाय कहते हैं पानी पीते हैं और पशुओं को चारा भी है
Thanks to these projects, about 30,000 acres of agricultural land is now under irrigation. It has benefited more than 6 lakh people and 12 lakh cattle in about 230 villages of Rajasthan and Haryana.
पहले एक फसल भी नहीं होती थी, पीने को जहाँ पानी नहीं हो वहाँ फसल कहाँ से होगी? बिल्कुल बंजर भूमि थी, और आज तो तीसरी फसल की भी लोग बात करते हैं, सब्जियाँ लगाने लगे हैं।
पहले हमारे 8 के करीब कुंटल होता था बीघे में, अब की बार 15 कुंटल गेहूँ देखा है हमने, हमको बड़ी तगड़ी खुशी है। तो हम तो पीएचडी वालों को चला चला के नौता दे रहे हैं कि आओ हमारे एक चेक डैम और बना दो, हम पैसा इकट्ठा कर रहे हैं आराम से आगे इकट्ठा कर रहे हैं।
In fact, round the year availability of water has enabled them to earn a livelihood by growing vegetables.
हमारे परिवार की ऐसी हालत थी कि हमको सुबह का खाना था मिलता तो शाम को नहीं मिलता, शाम को मिलता सुबह का नहीं मिलता। ऐसी गरीब हालत से मैं दिल्ली कमाने लिए चला गया। दिल्ली में हम पीठ पे भी वजन ढोते, सिर पे भी ढोते, हाथ हिला भी चलाना पड़ता था हमको। फिर हमारे यहाँ ये डंप बनने से, इनमें पानी भरने से, खेती करने से हम वापसी यहीं आ गए। इसी तरह मेरे साथ भी कई आदमी होते, वो भी धीरे धीरे हमारे गाँव वाले यहीं रुक गए और खेती पर आश्रित हो गए, खेती करने लगे, इससे हमको अच्छी पैदावार मिलने लगी।
Our next attempt is going to be a unique new system whereby we increase the productivity of water. We want to set up piping systems right from the water harvesting check dam up to the fields of the farmer with drip irrigation. That is going to be the next major jump in the entire process.
Apart from addressing the paucity of water, the PHD Rural Development Foundation seeks to improve the quality of life through integrated development of the villages in its project areas. Benefits of watershed management have been coupled with the formation of self-help groups, which has had a direct impact on the economic sovereignty of rural womenfolk. So far, about 43 SHGs have been formed and about 36 have been linked with the banks. Simultaneously, income augmenting projects like traditional embroidery work have been taken up.
आर्थिक स्थिति से बहुत परेशान थे, और तो पास थोड़े-थोड़े पैसे रहते थे। अब वो पैसे मतलब थोड़े-थोड़ों को हम जमा करने लग गए। उन्होंने मतलब बैंक के बारे में कुछ बातें हमें बताई, तो उनको हम जमा करने लगा। जमा करे तो वो थोड़े से इकट्ठे हुए, तो हमको लोन भी मिला बैंक से। बैंक से 50,000 का लोन उठा करके, जिनके पास भैंस नहीं थी उन्होंने भैंसें ली, और दूध की मतलब दूध चालू करा था। थोड़ा बहुत उनकी आर्थिक स्थिति और भी मतलब अच्छी हुई, तो उनसे फिर मतलब लोन को लौटाने के बाद में फिर बाद में उन्होंने पैसे जुड़े, तो अब उन 1,00,000 लोन उठाने के सबने प्रस्ताव रखा है, सभी महिलाओं ने। तो वो प्रस्ताव हम आज बैंक में ले गए थे, उसे स्वीकार कराया बैंक ने।
The foundation has also taken upon itself the task of improving the sanitation facilities in other villages. It has constructed about 150 toilets for the rural community in various villages of Alwar and Sikar.
Yaar maine pehle saab main 200 ja raha tha, unne saab truck se takra go, ye pair se saab godo toot gayo ya takuni toot gayo, aur ab saab mujhe paidal chali ja ko ne aur phone dole phire kon ja साबिंग गांव में लेटरिंग बाथरूम कोई कहीं को नहीं, तो संस्था से जे हमारे लिए यहाँ लेटरिंग बना रहा है, तो हमारे लिए थोड़ो आराम हो जाओ।
Besides, about 100 adult and non-formal education and learning centers for women and children are being run in the villages of Haryana. Special plantation drive has been undertaken for school children with a view to inculcate in them a sense of responsibility towards their environment. To enrich the habitat further, plant nurseries provided by the foundation are being raised by the villagers in several villages. In the health sector, its sister organization, the PHD Family Welfare Foundation, has intervened to impact the life of the villagers. In addition to periodic medical camps, a well-equipped mobile medical van has been put in service in remote areas of Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh and Haryana.
PHD took this initiative as far as back as 26 years back, and PHD is an organization. Currently we have a member strength of 1700 members. As people are aware, the larger corporations, they have their own CSR capabilities and spending where they do it. But medium and small scale, we have pulled them together to do this here CSR activities in various states.
The Family Welfare Foundation has also been actively conducting awareness programs and clinics on the identification and prevention of HIV/AIDS among the high-risk groups in the industrial areas of Delhi. Probable individuals are encouraged by the health volunteers to visit the PhD-run center in the neighborhood for clinical diagnosis and treatment. In Delhi, over the last 20 years, PhD has partnered with the state government to bring about a healthy change in the life of the urban poor.
Before 20 years, when we used to go to the field, they used to say ki operation wali aa rahi hai, darwaja band karo. But now they are coming for the operation ki madam hame le chalo. This difference PhD has created.
I can't help but be impressed. We're impressed by the work, we're impressed by the workmanship, we're impressed by the teamwork that has gone into these projects, and I'm deeply impressed by the smiles on the village people, recognizing that this is a sustainable project and will be there to serve them for many years.
From the rural settings of Rajasthan to the urban poor settlements of Delhi, the two philanthropic arms of the PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry have been trying to make a difference in the lives of the poor and the underprivileged. Be it water scarcity or health and hygiene, the foundations continue to allocate committed resources to revitalize the community in a holistic manner. In doing so, they have been in tune with the motto, "In communities, life and part of it."